Then absolutely it is justified. I mean, there's absolutely no issue for concern. But we are aware of the fact that in Gulbarga, we still have serious concerns about the number of institutional deliveries that happen, or maternal heart mortality deaths, and the disease control, I mean, disease related problems that we have. An absolute decline in this kind of an expenditure is a cause for definitely a serious, it's a serious issue for concern as such. Whereas, Chitradurga is definitely a better managed district where, although they have a decline in disease control program, they have a much better allocation for RCH as such. What happens to the per capita expenditure? I think earlier I referred to this particular issue. When you look at these two districts, Gulbarga definitely has much lesser in terms of per capita. What is it that we are doing? We are saying that Gulbarga gets the highest priority, but then in terms of per capita allocation, we still don't have as much as we need to have. This is about fund decentralization. I think Gautam was referring to fund decentralization. Now that there is existing evidence which shows clearly that better fund decentralization certainly helps in better outcomes and results and things like that. If you really look at the decentralization that we have among the facilities, it is in Gulbarga, what happens is a major portion of the funds go to district hospital actually. Okay, district hospital and the layers down, the facilities down below the district hospital level are getting much lesser as compared to Chitradurga. At this moment, I am not in a position to say how far it is going to impact, because this has to be looked along with other issues even before we make any comments as to how it gets translated into outcomes as such. What are the major cost drivers? All of us know salary is a major, source of expenditure. There's nothing to, criticize the sector on this, because it's a sector basically driven. It's a service sector where it is mainly the services of the doctors which are the most important. And there's nothing to really bother about having a high salary component. Definitely, it has to be associated with adequate infrastructure. That has been an issue. But what you find here again is, between the two districts, what you find is the district hospital, both on account of treasury and NRHM, Gulbarga has a very high component as compared to that of Chitradurga as such. Here I was just trying to link it up with the staff strength. What happens, and we are also actually, I should have said this right in the beginning, this is a study, ongoing study. We are still trying to explore reasons for some of these. So lots of work is still going on in this particular area. So what we were trying to do was, if we are talking about district hospital in Gulbarga having a very high component of expenditure, which category is getting the biggest share, whether it is a doctor, paramedical staff, or group A, group B, group C. What we come to know, I mean, like this can be examined in more leisure, but then there's a lot of variation between sanctioned, working, and the vacant position. And for every doctor that Chitradurga DH has, 1.74 group, group C officers, Gulbarga has about 5.62 of them. What happens? Yes, I'm just approaching my last slide. So the poor alignment of releases and expenditure as such, these graphs are self-explanatory. I don't have to really go into the details. This absolute mismatch between the releases and expenditure at all levels. Then this is a point I would like to make about the bunching of expenditure. Most of the items, the fund that is released or the expenditure that happens is to the fag end of the year, that's March. I have a link table with this where we have completely listed all the facilities when they get the funds, and sometimes it's on March 24, sometimes February, sometimes even the next year. So, and in fact, there were also cases when the bills were kept ready for submission. So here also I have some kind of link tables. I'm not in a position to show them. But basically, what are the policy correctives that we have to look at? We need to definitely link the program implementation plans, releases and expenditure to have the best optimal outcomes. Then planning rigor has to be really enhanced, and then we have to see what has to be focused. We have to really strictly adhere to financial year releases and expenditure. We have to really streamline the rush of expenditure. And of course, I really do not want to go into the details of how exactly the maternity benefits are reaching the beneficiaries. A lot was said about that yesterday, that they reach them after much later after the event as such. While most of these issues, I mean, as to why these things are happening were highlighted by Gautam, one issue which was left out was the capacity building. when we were talking to the officers at the grassroots level, an issue which came up very clearly was they were not aware of the fact whether they could really spend this money, including the untied grant. They come out with a concept saying united grant. I mean, like, basically they do not even know for what purpose they can send. So they basically accumulate for almost 3 years and then sort of spend it in one go. I mean, are we really, sir? I mean, is the entire untied fund helping them? There are also cases where these untied funds get utilized for purposes like purchase of DVDs or television sets. Are we really spending the money in the right manner? I think these are some of the issues that need to be taken care of. Thank you.